meditation is mostly concerned with the mind. We need to be mindful. The most important object of mindfulness is our mind at the present moment. To know the truth of the mind we are using is really important. Knowing about the mind as usual is not complete. We used to misunderstand the mind as something we own. Whenever we use the mind, there is misunderstanding as something we own. If we are not skillful in the practice of meditation or mindfulness, we cannot understand about our wrong view or misunderstanding. Most of the living beings are using the body and mind. But we are using with ignorance and attachment. Because of ignorance or misunderstanding, we are misusing our life or our body and mind. If there is ignorance, there will be attachment. In fact, ignorance and attachments are the real creator of all living beings and non-living beings. If we don't know about ignorance and attachment, we may misunderstand that someone or God create all living beings and non-living beings. In the practice of mindfulness, we can know the present moment mind. The present moment mind is changing time after time because of the ignorance and attachment, which is controlling behind the mind. If we are obeying our desire, to eat, to sleep, to go, to think, we will always be busy by these actions or activities. Instead of obeying our mind or desire, we should do good deeds. We should do all kinds of good deeds with mindfulness and detachment. because of ignorance and attachment, we are misunderstanding living beings and non-living beings as true or real. Only mindfulness and detachment can know the truth of ever new impermanent nature and permanent nature. Therefore, we all need to change from ignorance and attachment to mindfulness and detachment. We need to know about our own ignorance and attachment. The practice of mindfulness is essential to know the mind at the present moment, and then ignorance and attachments, which is controlling the present moment mind. The present moment, ignorance and attachment is hidden behind our present moment mind. If we don't know our present moment mind, we cannot know the present moment ignorance and attachment. As a new meditator, we are free to be mindful on everything most of the meditators are mindful on our own breath. If we are feeling pain, the suffering of the pain is the object of mindfulness. We can use one of the object within our body and mind, body or mind, at the present moment. The more we are mindful within ourselves or our body and mind, the more we can detach from the others. The practice of mindfulness is useful to control the mind step by step from exterior to interior. Most of the people in modern age are suffering from stress. Stress or disappointment. Or wandering of the mind. Using the mind for education or business or art or music or politics are the cause of mental problems. To solve all the mental problems, we should practice mindfulness and detachment every day. the truth of all living beings and non-living beings are to use or not to use. To do or not to do, to know or not to know, to experience or not to experience only. Neither rejecting nor attaching. Not to reject, we can use our life or our body and mind for education, for business, for ourselves or for our family, for our country. But not to attach, we all should practice mindfulness and detachment. The more we are skillful in the practice of mindfulness, the more our mind will be stable. The practice of mindfulness is the best way of controlling the mind to be stable and pure. Stability is the well of the mind. Stable mind is wealthy. Unstable mind is poor. Purification is the health of the mind. Your mind is healthy. Greedy or angry or doubtful. Mind is not healthy. Most of the people in the society are busy with healthy and wealthy of the life, not the mind. By paying more attention to the life or material, we are rejecting the practice of mindfulness and detachment. That is the cause of more and more mental problems in a society. if we are rejecting education, or family or friends or business, there will be problems of concerned with education, family and business. If we are rejecting the practice of mindfulness and detachment, there will be problems concerned with the mind. They are cause and effect. All living beings are concerned with cause and effect. We are what we do. We get what we give to the others. Thinking only for ourselves and working or doing only for ourselves is not the right way. If we are able to think and work, we should use our ability not only for us, but also for the others who are in need. We used to see only from our side. One-sided view is not complete. That's why no one is complete. Nothing is complete. We should try to see not only from our side, but also from the other side. Besides, we should try to see from the side of the truth. We all should have three sides of view. One is our side, that is what we used to do. The second is the side of the others, and the dust, or the last one is the side of the truth. Whatever we do, we should try to do by using all these three sides. Whenever we use one of the sides, we should not forget the rest two sides. In this way, we will be able to do only with mindfulness and detachment. Each side of view is to use only, not to reject and attach. Grasping use is wrong. Knowing or thinking or speaking or doing only from one side is not complete. We can never be satisfied by using one-sided view. Even the side of the truth cannot be grasped as mine or something. The truth of not something, not someone, just ever new environment and nature is also to use only. If we are grasping the truth of ever new environment and nature, we may misunderstand that no I. That's why no need to do good deeds. No need to be free from ignorance and attachment. If we see from our side, we will misunderstand that I'm right. I'm good. I am the most important. It is the same if we see from the side of the other. The other person was the same. The same the other person will know the same. He is right, he is good. He is the most important of all. If we see from the side of the truth, which is ever new impermanent nature, there is no living beings, no non-living beings, no I, no you, not mine, not yours. Just appearing and disappearing, of ever new impermanent nature only. Doing all kinds of good deeds, including meditation, is the cause of knowing the truth. Now we all are meditating. Therefore, we all have chance to know the truth if we are skillful in doing all kinds of good deeds with mindfulness and detachment. Teaching is about the truth. It will be helpful to know the truth or to have the right view. Concerned with the truth. Although you are dealing with teaching about the truth, you may not understand my teaching if you are grasping the idea of something or someone. I emphasize to be right teaching or explanation about the truth. If I am explaining in the wrong way about the truth, I'm doing bad to the others, to have wrong view about the truth. If I made the others to have wrong view about the truth, I will also be far away to know the truth. We should know the truth. We should speak rightly about the truth. to know, think, speak and do what is true and right is really important for us. This teaching will be helpful for you all. To be dealing with the truth. This teaching is based on practice. As a meditation master, I am responsible to solve the problems of the meditators and the other people in the society who are in need of help. Because of dealing what is not right and true, we are doing and getting what is bad. Because of dealing and doing what is right and true, we can accumulate merits or good deeds. Which are the cause of good result. Only practice will make perfect. Knowing what is right is not complete. We both need to know and do what is right. We are what we do. If we are knowing and doing what is right, we can get what we want. Our desire will be fulfilled by our action of good deeds. Instead of paying attention to ourselves as who we are all. How old we are, or how much educated we are, we should pay attention to know and do what is right and good. There are only cause and effect. If we can change the cause, the effect or result will change for sure. This is teaching about the truth or the essence of meditation practice. Is there any question or sharing your own experience?
Never understanding it before, but it made me and everything in myself so calm that only by listening to your words I was feeling such a deep state of meditation I was never having before.
This kind of practice can make the mind to be stable, calm, and peaceful. This practice can purify the mind. So the mind is the most important, even in this kind of teaching. The mind I'm using is the most important than my teaching. This is for everyone, for every action. If we are using the stable and pure stability and purification power of the mind, you can get success. Whatever you do, this is using the power, using the help and will of the mind. Healthy and wealthy mind is much more better than healthy and wealthy life. instead of thinking about the meaning of life, we should think about our mind. What is the truth of the mind? We should emphasize the mind rather than the life or living beings or non-living beings. They are only cause and effect. There will be many methods . Every method had the result concern, so we need to choose the right one for us. This practice is helpful to detach from the others. The more we practice like this, the more we can detach from the others. But this practice is also to use only, not to reject and attach. We should try to be doing only whatever we do. To do with mindfulness and detachment. Knowing about our present ignorance and attachment is also knowing the truth. The more we know about the present moment, ignorance and attachment, there will be less and less ignorance and attachment. This is the way of purification of the mind. We are using impure mind, therefore we can never be free from ignorance and attachment. instead of paying attention to the others, trying to pay attention the mind at the present moment. It will be helpful to be more and more stable and pure mind. We just need to change the mind. We just need to change the view we are using. In order to change our own view, we need to detach from our habit. As a human beings, we want to change the others. We may want to change the wall. We may want to change the place or the car. We are using. We may want to change our life. By paying attention to change our view, we should detach from all of our habits. We also try to be doing only whatever we do. If we are able to be doing only with mindfulness and detachment, we can get what we want. Whatever we do will be successful. If we are doing with ignorance and attachment, it will be difficult to get success. We should understand that no one is complete, nothing is complete. That's why we should detach from relying on someone or something. we should not keep someone or something in the mind. We should keep the truth of doing or not doing only, using or not using only, in order to detach something or someone from the mind. Any question or sharing? You should share what you know.
Today we took a walk near to the East Side Gallery to see the remains of the wall, and we asked Sayadaw to stop by one piece of the drawing where there were works which depicted very nicely his way of teaching, his way of doing. It was written there something like, small people in small places do small things, and by this they can change the world. So this is actually what Sayadaw teaches us to do good deeds from moment to moment, and to do not for one, not for someone we know who is our family or friend, but to do for all. So this is the practice during which we can apply the teaching of the theory. And in the theory he teaches about the truth. And in comparison to other masters, Sayadaw doesn't try to explain simple things which we can understand with our simple mind. Sayadaw teaches something that we can understand only if we can abandon all that we know. And then we can understand the truth. In order to be able to abandon what we know, we need to practice mindfulness with detachment. And practicing mindfulness with meditation is not enough to do once. We should do it continuously. Because if we want to change our life, we need to be able to overcome our habits. So is good, it is helpful, but it is not enough. We also need to listen to explanations to Dhamma talk. And we have recordings in English of Sayadaw teaching, which can be helpful during meditation. Like we could hear now sharing that even the voice of Sayadaw, even the space between the words, gives us some help in meditation. So we already had experience during our trip in Europe that some people were telling they cannot meditate long because there are too many thoughts on their mind. And after listening to Sayadaw, after trying to meditate with him, after trying to follow his teaching and trying to apply it, they came back to a new session, to a new city where they followed us, and they said that their meditation practice changed. They can meditate longer and they can feel their path better. So, in my case, I find it very useful to do both, also to meditate and also to listen to the teaching. The teaching of Sayadaw is applicable for all situations. We can listen it in sitting meditation, or we can listen it while driving, or walking, or working, like I mean, doing some household things. Sometimes we may miss some information, some words, but if we listen again and again, we will feel together with his teaching. Even if we listen attentively his teaching and we are not busy with anything else, anyway his teaching will not discover itself fully from the first time. The teaching of Sayadaw has layers. One layer can be just feeling the teaching. Another layer can be the information. When we can understand something, when something can match us as a puzzle. But then the more we practice and the more we listen to the teaching, the more we can understand and we can remove layer by layer and hear new things in the same teaching. Today he explained to you the full picture of understanding the truth and how we should practice and what is important. He gave very much information, but everybody could understand what we could understand. Even if you hear the same information, after some time, you can discover something new. But the main aspect of the teaching as I find it is being mindful. And there are many objects that we can be mindful of. But most important is our mind. Because everything depends on the mind. So if we can be mindful of the mind, then we can know the present moment happening. And then we can practice detachment. It is easier to detach if we know the present moment happening rather than if we try to detach from something big, whole, that we believe as real.
to detach from the meditation yourself. Important object of mindfulness is the truth. This is to do, to know, to experience, to use only. Besides, ever new impermanent nature is also the most important object of mindfulness. To do, doing only, or using only, is concerned with whatever we do, whatever we use. We may be using online, we may be driving a car, we may be using money, we may be doing meditation, we may be eating. Whatever we do, we should be mindful of the truth of doing only, with mindfulness and detachment. To be doing only, mindfulness is essential. If there is mindfulness, there will be detachment. The more we are mindful on the practice of doing all kinds of good deeds, the more we can detach from what we used to do as a human beings in the society. In my own experience, I started meditation as a businessman. If I don't meditate, I cannot detach from running my own business. I cannot detach from my life as a businessman. I have to try to meditate as a businessman. It is also really difficult. If I cannot stop my business for some of the period, I cannot meditate. Before I meditate, I was thinking about my business all the time. I was busy with my business all the time. The more I can meditate, the more I can detach from my job and from my life. I have to meditate as a businessman. I have to meditate at the meditation center. Besides, I have to do business as a meditator. I have to meditate at home also. Meditation or mindfulness and detachment practices for anyone, for any life, not only for the life of meditator, but also for the life of a layman, for a businessman, or for a patient. Meditation is for everywhere, not only for the meditation center, but also for the home, for the job, for the hospital, if we are sick, if we are taking treatment at the hospital, we need to practice mindfulness and detachment. Seeing from the side of something or someone is not complete. If we see from our side, there are differences between ourselves and the others. They are not the same between outside and inside, exterior and interior. They are different. But if we see from the side of the truth, everything or everyone or outside or inside or exterior or interior, all are the same avenue, environment and nature, or appearing and disappearing nature only. So the truth, seeing from the side of the truth, is not different, no inside, no outside, not this one, not that one, not this person, not that person, only appearing and disappearing nature. So if we are mindful on exterior, we should know that we should try to find out the truth of avenue, environment and nature. If we are mindful ourselves, we should trying to find out the truth of avenue, environment and nature. In this way, we may understand no difference no difference between each other. No difference between the place, between the time. No difference between good or bad condition. No difference between man or woman, living beings or non-living beings. No difference between yin or yang. In this way, there will be no problems if we can see from the side of the truth. That is complete. The truth is complete. No one is complete. Nothing is complete. Only the truth is complete. Therefore, we should know the truth and we should be the one with the truth. Only cause and effect, knowing the truth and not knowing the truth only. There is no one who knows the truth. There is nothing which knows the truth. Only knowing the truth and only not knowing the truth. So if we understand this cause and effect, no need to be proud of ourselves or no need to underestimate the others. Everyone is the same. Everything is the same. Every condition is the same. Every place is also the same. The same avenue, environment and nature. In this way, we should be the one with the truth of avenue, environment and nature. Only knowing about the truth of impermanent nature is the cause of knowing permanent nature. That is the end or destination of the practice. Impermanent nature is, knowing impermanent nature is not complete. Knowing permanent nature is complete. Permanent by nature, no creation. There is no creator. The nature is complete by itself. The mind can be satisfied only when there is wisdom about permanent nature. Therefore, the most important is not someone, not something, not the time and not the place, not the method. Just right view and action at the present moment. Many people in the world are in need of help. We can use the power of the truth to help the others. That is the best we can do. Your question is?
The question is like Buddha mentioned in Dhamma. Dhamma and the one practice, you know, someone practice mindfulness and detachment, which will lead to the knowing the truth, which is ever new in permanent nature. And through the knowing that in permanent nature,
it's the same. We can call as we went many languages. Therefore, many any concept, is it? Any concept about the wada, about the art. It will be different in names or concept, but the essence is the same. No one is permanent. Nothing is permanent. That's why we need to know permanent. So we trying to find the truth which is permanent. it is easy to know impermanence of something or someone. But that knowing is not complete. It cannot solve the problem. It cannot solve the problems of the mind. But we should understand that ignorance and attachment is the cause of not knowing the truth. So nothing is important. Money or power or fame or success or education, all these are not really important. No one is also important. To be well known or to be president or to be a rich person are also not really important. To know the truth, to know our own ignorance and attachment is really important. Ignorance and attachments are concerned, mostly concerned with the mind. Therefore, the mind is the most important of all. With this right understanding, we should be mindful from one of the objects such as breathing or moving of abandoned abdomen. But at the end, we should be mindful of the mind at the present moment. The mind itself is impermanent. Knowing of the mind is also impermanent. The action, the present action of mindfulness is also impermanence. We should be mindful, we should try to be mindful. Three kinds of impermanent concerned with the mind. The mind itself is impermanent. The knowing or not knowing of the mind is also impermanent. The present action of mindfulness is also impermanent. By the practice of mindfulness, we should trying to find out all the impermanence, whatever impermanence concerned with the mind. In this way, we will be able to make up our mind, or there will be decision, or wisdom, or intuition about nothing, not something, not someone, just ever new impermanent nature only. Not our mind, no I, not mind, just ever new impermanent nature is the truth, which is permanent. The essence of meditation should be to know the permanent nature of impermanent. That is the first step of right view. If we understand this kind of truth, we should practice. We should try to practice in our, we should try to practice all the time in our daily life to make sure of the truth, or to be right view and action, we should apply it. We should apply the truth in our daily life until we can detach from impermanent nature. If we don't know about impermanent nature, we cannot detach. If we cannot detach, we cannot know permanent nature or real freedom, real peace of the mind. All these steps are necessary to be a complete practice of meditation. There are misunderstandings about Dhamma, or about Four Noble Truths, about Nibbana, or about meditation. That's why I advise using all these concepts. I'm trying to use new concept, not to misunderstand the truth. In this way, there will be less misunderstanding concerned with the concept or name I'm using.
specify what new concept you mean?
Created truth. Original truth. Impermanent nature. Permanent nature. Detachment. These are new works or concept I used to detach from old concept or common works used in meditation. But the word I'm using is not important. The way of using only with mindfulness and detachment is really important. If I'm using with attachment, it will make the people who listen my teaching will not be easy to be using only. I'm teaching about using only. Besides, I'm trying to practice using only, doing only. Not only by works, but also by practice, I teach my teaching. Rather than the works, I emphasize the practice of doing only, the power of doing only. I emphasize the power of doing only, rather than the power of the works or concept or theory. Most of the people are using the power of the works or the power of someone, the power of something, the power of the place. That is not the best. The power of the truth is complete. I emphasize to be right speech or right explanation. Rather than the people who are listening, I'm not emphasized whether you understand or not. I don't emphasize too much the understanding of the person who is listening. This is not only for you. This I'm teaching for all. I'm teaching for the truth to be doing only. I emphasize not to make mistakes in my teaching and to be teaching only with mindfulness and detachment. This is the same to you all. I want you to be mindful your own physical or verbal or mental action to be right action and to be doing only, to be knowing or not knowing only. To do or not to do with mindfulness and detachment. To know or not to know with mindfulness and detachment. We are what we do. That's why what we are doing now is the most important of all. Instead of doing with ignorance and attachment, we should try to be doing only with mindfulness and detachment. Any question or sharing?
Is there any concept or any idea that Sayadaw is sharing and he could explain more? That maybe something is not clear.
I would love to, because you say when you are teaching the truth, it doesn't matter who are here but you're teaching. So the resonance of the teach is just spreading around. You mind that? Or
to be doing only is the most important of all. If I am doing with attachment, it will not much helpful for you and the others to be doing only. The key is, the essence is, whatever we do, or whatever we think, or whatever we speak or listen, we should do with mindfulness and detachment. That is the most important. The object of mindfulness, or the time and place, or the life we use to be mindful is not much important. If we think the method is important, the place, the time, the person, the master or the follower is important, that is, that is wrong. Time, place, person, methods are created through. We accept I'm important. That's why we are important, because the method is important. The place is important, because we agree, we accept it as important. If we stop thinking like this, it will not be important. And nowadays, if most of the people accept money is the most important, money will be important, because most of the people think money is the most important. That is, we create, people create money to be the most important things. So it can be changed. To know about ignorance and attachment, or to know about incompleteness of someone or something is the most important. This is true by itself. Because the creator is not someone special, just ignorance and attachment. That's why ignorance and attachment itself is not important, not something which is complete. That's why all living beings are not really important. This is the right view of mindfulness and detachment. So if we are grasping ignorance and attachment, we are difficult to accept this, to accept the truth. But if we try, we are sure to accept the truth, to be the one with the truth. So the truth is really difficult even to accept or understand. To apply in our daily life is really difficult, the most difficult of all. Some of the people may understand the truth, but they cannot practice in their daily life because they don't want to make against the others. Because we don't want to be against with our family, with our friends. So that's why we need to create a new organization like meditation center to do good deeds together, to get out of the society, to change our life, to change our view. It's really difficult to practice. That's why we need to be united. We need teamwork. We need to do good deeds together.
Summarize maybe the answer of Sayadaw, that there is an that you talk about comes due to his non-attachment in the teaching, because as he teaches, he's not teaching only now here for this yoga hall, for these people, and it is not that he is emphasizing the current teaching. He's teaching only, he's letting the nature happen, and this is why his teaching resonates so much and creates this special, probably for you, feeling, and gives opportunity to understand something new. Because without attachment, it is for all. With attachment, it is directed to one, to someone. So knowing the truth, Sayadaw is not teaching to someone, and he is not teaching something. It is just ever new impermanent nature happening. It is just moment by moment, which we are experiencing.
If I have a project, I should use my mind and should use my words to unite people, to make people just flowing in one way, to reach or to create this project. What I understood is that I don't have to be attached to the result of what I wish to create. But in the moment I have my idea or I have my power to do something, then I'm somehow a little bit attached to this project. You know what I mean? And I think this kind of attachment, if we want to call it like attachment, is something that empower myself and also the people, and also for the good, because maybe I want to do something for the people, like you did or do. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Yeah. I think the right way is not to be attached to the result, what I'm doing. But when I'm doing something, I have to be able to empower myself and not to be like kind of, I don't want to be the best or the beautiful, or but just to be there for what I'm doing is good. You know, and sometimes the our culture, because we are creator, I think, and the culture, our culture, they make us just be smaller for me, as my feeling. It's not really the power we got about the ego is not the right power we have to discover in our life. You know what I mean? I'm a bit unbalanced. There is a certain unbalance for me. Can you explain me? Maybe if you understood what I meant.
Yeah, but you are in project to become a yogi. Oh, no? Oh, so you are in China, you are in the middle of the world. I'm going to tell you that I'm in the middle of the world. I'm going to tell you that I'm in the middle of the world. That's the other thing.
Not only to detach from the result, but also we need to detach from the cause we are doing. Instead of relying on yourself, you should try to rely on the cause of doing only. no need to stop what you are doing. Just need to change the power you are using. If you are thinking about yourself, that is, you are using the power of someone. If you can stop thinking about yourself and the others, you are using the power of beyond someone. For me, before I meditate, I love thinking. I think about my job, my own business all the time. I was busy for nearly 7 years, thinking only my business, only my job, what to do, how to do, where to do. But when I meditate, I understand the power of doing with ignorance and attachment is not the best. So we must be able to think, to speak, to do. Besides, we must be able not to think, not to speak, not to do. In this way, the power which can stop thinking, speaking, or doing is much more better than the power of doing with ignorance and attachment. So like, if we want to stop thinking, it is much more difficult to not to abandon thinking is more difficult than thinking. To stop speaking is more difficult than speaking. To stop doing is more difficult than doing. That's why if we can stop, we don't need to think. We don't need to speak too much. We don't need to do like before. We can get good idea if we can stop thinking. We can make people know without speaking if you can stop speaking. The power of abandoning is better than the power of doing. So in this way, we can change the power we are using. The power which can stop doing is the power of the powers beyond something or someone. We are thinking only to use the power of something, the power of nuclear, the power of solar, the power of high technology. That is not complete. Only when we try to stop using cigarette or alcohol or drugs, it is really difficult. If we can stop what we do, no need to do, but we can get what we want with the power which can stop doing. So to change the power, it is similar to automatic. By thinking, speaking, doing are manual, like manual, we have to emphasize. If we can stop using manual power, we can use automatic power. We can get good idea without thinking. That is the best we can do. We will be skillful. We can get the best idea if we are able to think and if we can stop thinking. We can get the best result if we can do and if we can stop doing. If we see from the side of the truth, instead of using the power of ignorance and attachment, which is not complete, we should use the power of mindfulness and detachment, which is complete. Because of teamwork, we are here together. That's why we can do we all can create a good teaching and question and answer. This is teamwork. If I'm alone, I cannot do. If I am teaching in other place, in the East, I cannot teach like this. Because you can understand, because you are interested. You are interested in the truth. That's why there is good result than before. This is the way I use the power of teamwork. If more and more people are joining in this practice, in this kind of good deeds, there will be better result in the future. So in this way, we can solve, we together can solve the problems of the truth. It is really difficult. If you try by yourself or if I try by myself, it will be difficult. We have to work together, who are doing good deeds, who are meditating. If we can solve the problems concerned with the truth, we can solve all the problems, for sure. The problems of the truth is the most difficult of all. The other problems are not much difficult. Stop now, is it? Because of the limit of the time. For the Bawa. In the Bawa Zenda, no limit of the time. So therefore, we can keep on the whole night.
would like to share one more thing that you were speaking now, and it reminded me about another important thing about meditation that Sayadaw says we should. It is possible to do because we do together. It is possible to have this teaching and to have meditation together. And I want to mention here about the importance of doing meditation like this together. Because when we do meditation, we create, we do it for the good not only of ourselves, but also of the others. Because we create new cause and we create new example. Well, if we continue doing what others do, if now we were not here in this hall doing meditation and speaking about the truth, we would be just doing everything that others do. But being here meditating, we give an example to them that there is something else, something different from what we already know that we can do. So by doing it by ourselves, we also give a chance for others to have a glimpse, little bit glance on what else is there existing. And like this, we kind of introduce to them the subject of meditation slightly. And after knowing that it is possible to do what we do, they can also be interested and also can start practicing meditation. And doing meditation is always good because there is even no chance that we hurt somebody or do something bad because we are just sitting in silence. We are not even moving, there is no chance that we can step over some ant, any insect, so we cannot kill, we cannot say something bad, we cannot create anything bad. So there are many benefits of meditation. This is why it is important to continue and to work with.
Yeah. Can we just finish with a very short meditation together? Can you?
Just a very short meditation.
Oh, yes, yes. How long? Yes, yes. In silence, yes. Okay. abandon or let go of our pleasant action. We are able to think of doing something. We should try to abandon thinking of doing something. We are able to do something. We should try to abandon of doing something. We are able to do by force. We should try not to do by force. Trying to be natural. able to control the mind. We should try to stop controlling the mind.